Yeah.
All right, we're in Machias, Maine. And I've just come across a collective called the Beehive Collective. Is that right?
Yes.
All right, so introduce yourself to the world and
Hello.
Tell us what it's all about.
My name is Erin B. I'm a member of the Beehive Design Collective. We're an all-volunteer organization of artists, activists, educators, and organizers. And that's a fancy way of saying that what we do is make giant cartoons that explain the world visually.
Excellent. Yeah. So give us a little, just pick one small section, because this
one
huge.
Small section. Sure. One small section, which will give you a little insight to exactly how we do it, is right here. We're talking about greenwashing. We're talking about how industries like tourism, oil, timber, and biotechnology and private water privatization are putting on green faces to continue doing their work in the midst of a society that's trying to like go green. And here we show that they're each pretending to be green with their masks, but they're cutting up a cake that is in the shape of the area of the world from Puebla, Mexico to the Panama Canal. This is a place where there is huge amounts of rainforest, and the PPP, the Plan Puebla Panama, which has been renamed to Project Mesoamerica, is attempting to make huge amounts of infrastructure development, huge roads, giant pipelines, oil pipelines, pretty much every way to expedite the process of getting stuff from South America to North America as fast as possible at the costs of the livelihoods of the people who live in this place in the world. And so, what's going on right here is you can see a bit of our process because we work together to figure out metaphors. We're showing this greenhouse where they're keeping animals in 2x2s. This is the industries that are planning the Mesoamerica project are actually saying that we're going to protect the ecosystem there, and we're sort of making the metaphor to this akin to Noah's Ark. So here they've got all the animals chained up in 2x2s, and they're being piped into this table where underneath it looks like a stage, and they've got this Noah's Ark sort of, we're saving them, don't worry, 2x2. And what we're trying to say is that another thing that's going into the table to make this process work is the hearts and minds of the people, of the American people. But we spend a lot of our time working on metaphors, and we're trying to figure out the best way to draw it.
Wow.
And we work together to figure that metaphor out. Right now it's brains and hearts on a conveyor belt, and we're not confident that it's actually the best visual metaphor.
We actually are going to go with that.
You're going to go with that?
Yeah, we just discussed it.
We just figured it out? All right.
Cool.
Awesome. Well, there we go.
Fantastic.
Also, we had to spend time deciding whether or not the term hearts and minds translates into Spanish, because that's also a huge part of our demographic that we're trying to draw for. And
which it does. My friend in Mexico said it does.
Yes, we just found out that
Yay.
Hearts and minds does translate.
Translate into what?
Hey, what does it translate into?
Spanish.
How do you say it?
Oh, okay.
Say like mentes y corazones, but it's like
mentes y corazones?
Yeah. It sounds kind of literal in Spanish, but only recently it's been more like commonly used.
Yeah, what we just learned from Juan is that the term hearts and minds in Spanish wasn't popular and made sense until recently during the war in Iraq, when the American government has been using that phrase so much that now it is a phrase that's used.
Wow, holy smokes.
Holy smokes. Anyways.
Well, awesome. Thank you so much for
good to meet
explaining
you.
That. And it's all about storytelling, as you were mentioning.
Yes,
a second
it is.
Ago.
It's about transmitting knowledge verbally and visually, instead of having to read a textbook, which I know is not the way that I learn.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much.
Yeah.
All right. There you go. You learn something new every day, and this is very valuable knowledge. Awesome.
Also, you just